talk it over.
Hello, folks. All you Cape Ann people, welcome to our show. This is Local Music Scene, and I'm your host, Allen Estes. And as I always like to say in the very beginning of the show, we really appreciate you supporting live music and watching our show and getting out and checking some live music out around town. We're so blessed to have a lot of great singer-songwriters and musicians here on Cape Ann. And my guest today is one of them for sure, local girl. We're going to talk with her in just a second. But first, I get to do a song. Yeah, I do. And this is called We All Fall Down. Don't look now, but look who's back around. I heard that you'd been hiding for a while. It's good to see you out and on the town. I can tell it's been a rough road by your smile. Did you kick your ass so bad it left you scarred? Did you curse your dreams for never coming true? Oh, some of us, we take it really hard. Mostly sentimental fools like me and you. When we fall, it's always such a long way down. It only takes one thread to come unraveled. It only takes one note to wound a song. And it only takes one cloud to kill your shadow, leaving you alone, just barely hanging on. There's a lesson never too late for the learning. And those of us who've been there understand. The only rule of thumb for crash and burning is when you're taking off, someday you gotta land. 'Cause we all don't wake up until we hit the ground. And we fly
such a long way down.
We all fall down. Thank you, thank you. We have a bit of a live audience here. Welcome to our show. And please say hello to Nadia Robertson.
Hello.
Hi, sweetheart. How are you?
I'm good.
Oh, it's great to have you on. This is actually not Nadia's first time on. You were on with Wade Dice.
Yes.
And you were singing like a kind of a reggae thing, doing some shows?
Yep, it was Cultural Roots. And for a while, my friend Mosso and I were doing some backup in that. It was really fun.
Oh,
real
yeah.
Real fun time.
Great show. Still remember it. It was really having, good having you on then and a good having you on now. So we
got
a lot to talk about, but
yes.
Local girl right here too, by the way. Could we start with a song, though, please?
Absolutely.
Nadia Robertson.
Cry Me a River by Ella Fitzgerald.
Oh, yeah.
And cry me a river.
Beautiful. Wow. Fantastic.
Thank you.
Nadia, so great to have you on the show.
It's great to be here.
And you know, that is the best song to open with, because I want to ask you about how you got started singing, and that song's older than even me.
Oh, yeah.
So
obviously, somebody had to be teaching you some musical influences way back when. So how did you get started in this crazy business?
So basically what happened is when I was very young, probably, I want to say 3 years old, I got into piano playing mainly because my mom actually bought me like a very tiny piano that I used to play all the time when I was little. And then when I went to other places with her, and when those places had even bigger pianos, like the real grand pianos, I wasn't the kid who went up and started banging all over the keys. I actually played stuff, and it just kind of came naturally. So as I grew older and really learned about the talents I had and focused on it, once upon a time in sixth grade, we started with the musical Annie. And I was terrified, so terrified to try out for that musical. It was my first musical ever, first time being up on stage in front of who knows
acting
how many people.
Acting and singing, of course, right? Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, the full lot. So, I mean, I nearly backed out, to be completely honest with you, from trying out for that musical. And my mom sort of went, and she pushed me, and one day I tried out, and the next thing I know, I was playing one of the orphans in Annie with some solos and dancing and all that fun stuff, and I started to realize that I had this natural love for just music and for singing and wanting to be up on stage and making people smile with it. So
musicals was really your first dip mm-hmm. into the water, huh?
Oh, yeah. Musicals was my starter. And then from there on, I just kind of started listening to music, really getting into it. I got influences through it, lots of influences, which actually, with my last song later, one of my bigger influences of all time, I'll be playing a song by theirs.
Oh, that's so, excellent, excellent. Yeah. Well, you know, it's funny because I know that you've done a lot of acting, too. I mean, a lot of people who know you, because you live locally here, you're right on the Rockport-Lanesville line. I think when we first met, you were acting and performing in something, and that I was emceeing or something. And so whereabouts did that sort of separate a little bit? Because I know you still do acting, and you still love to be into that. And if a musical came along, you'd probably want to do both, But now you go out and you play around and you actually perform in some nightclubs and stuff like that. And when did that kind of wedge off a little bit?
Right. So there was a big separation between musicals and normal music for me. For musicals, there's a lot of acting and emotions to it. And it's sort of the same with normal music. And you'll see a lot of artists will use a lot of emotion as they create songs and as they sing them. But for me, it was big having to really separate the two. And I had to really figure out, you know, in musicals, I'm playing a character. I don't get to play myself. I don't get to be who I want to be with the music that I'm performing. I have to perform as the character I have to be. Mm-hmm. Whereas with music in general, even if I'm doing a cover, it's coming from me as a person. And many of the covers that I choose to do, aside from my originals, are covers that I really feel. Cry Me a River, for example, I really feel that song because I understand it. I get what it's like to have someone who completely disses you and now they're coming back and you're just kind of like, no, I want you to cry me a river. Like, I'm not bringing you back, not
yeah,
this
yeah.
time. I'm
you
sorry.
You want to name names.
Don't want to name names, but you know.
But so it's got to present itself an element of something that you can identify with because you've been through it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I get
yeah.
it. I get it. And that's wonderful because you just sang that so beautifully. And I mean, I kept thinking, you know, because you're young, where did you hear this song? I mean, now you can hear anything you want on the internet, but a lot of people your age hear, you know, their parents or something playing some of these old tunes in the background, and at the time, because my mom was the same way, and I grew up thinking, you know, I'm not so into Frank Sinatra, I like the Beatles, but now it's come around full circle, and it's like I love the stuff that was kind of going in one ear out the other for a little
oh, yeah.
while. It
yeah.
does stay there somewhere inside.
Well, for one thing, in school, well, I was in school through middle school and high school, I took chorus classes, which was really the only amount of vocal training I really ever had fully. And through those classes, I learned about all different music, from jazz to pop to rock to really way back in the Victorian Renaissance era. Oh. And certain music sort of stuck with me, but also, I mean, through my parents, again, they listened to a lot of music. I mean, their music switched up from Ella Fitzgerald to, like, Neil Diamond or to some bigger rock bands like Aerosmith and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I was just like, I don't want to, you know, settle myself with one particular genre. A lot of people will say, like, oh, your voice is so well built for jazz. And I'm like, I appreciate that so much, but jazz isn't where I want to be stuck.
Right, right, absolutely.
I want to have all of the variations of music because I know that every person out there has a certain particular music style they like, and I want to play for everyone.
Good
you know?
For you. Keep the parameters wide open.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We're talking with Nadia Robertson, and could we get another song?
Absolutely. So this is actually an original that I wrote recently, and this is called My Soul Still Flies.
Yeah. Excellent. Nadia Robertson.
But you'll never take my soul. My soul still flies. My soul, it still flies.
Beautiful. Oh. Oh, that one hurts in all the right places.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful song. And that's an original song that you wrote, Nadia.
Yes.
Nadia Robertson. Wow, we're talking with Nadia. That's a beautiful song. And, you know, couldn't be a better song to segue into what I want to talk about with you now, and that's the songwriting.
Perfect.
People, our viewing audience, always, when I run into them at the supermarket, they're like, we love the parts when you talk with your guests about the songwriting. And, you know, because that's really fun. It's pulling teeth sometimes, and it can, for us, it's a yin and yang thing, and it can be very dark, and but very enlightening, and can be all of it. But to let your emotions go, what works for you?
So what works for me normally is I like to write first. And the writing styles can kind of vary, but they are always focused off of a real life event. Something that not only I can relate to, but something that my entire audience could relate to. So obviously, as you saw with this song, I was bullied a lot through all of my school years. I mean, even till senior year in high school. Freshman year of high school, most of it went, you know, to the background, so it wasn't right in front of me like it was in the early days, but I knew it was still there, and you know, people would come up to me and be like, oh, this, you know, this person said something about you, and it definitely was a painful experience. It was definitely a shattering one, and I still have a lot of, you know, confidence issues to this day with what happened, but writing about it really helps me to just kind of explain how I'm feeling, and through music, because I love to really just say how I'm, you know, feeling through music and how to show it through music. I don't really know how to show it with words or to talk with people, because for me, talking to people has always been so hard. But as soon as I'm talking through music, it's so much easier. It just flows right out of me. So,
well, you took a difficult situation and you turned it into a real thing of beauty, which is an amazing accomplishment, I think. So that's unbelievable. But I'm getting from what you just said before that, so usually a storyline or some sort of a lyric or something that comes to you first before the melody.
Yes.
And so then when you get some sort of like say with that last song, when it starts to get to come together a little bit lyrically, then you'll sit down with the piano or whatever and you'll start coming up with a little melody and figuring out where your rhyming scheme might work and that kind of process?
Yes. My best friend ever would have to be a recording device. When I am writing the lyrics first, it helps to have some form of recording device in front of me, so that if I do have a melody in my head or a way that I would like the song to go, how I would like to sing it, I'll record separately my voice singing the lyrics in whatever rhythm, whatever tempo, whatever note or key that I would like it in. And then later on, when I find the time, I'll go over to the piano, I'll replay my recording, really listen to it. And then I'll attempt to start plunking away at it, and I'll do a few tweaks here and there, see if, you know, if I like, do I like this chord that it's in, do I not like this chord, is this too high, or is it too fast, should this song be slower? And that's usually how the process happens. When I mentioned that I do variations in writing styles, some of my writing is more like, I guess you could say a book, it's really just paragraph after paragraph, or I might even do a poem, and then I'll take whatever poem I wrote and transfer that into a song.
So the melodic thing, does it mostly come from ear, or do you actually like write notes down too and all that kind of thing?
So for me, and don't get me wrong, I did take piano lessons when I was a lot younger, but for me it was a lot easier to really just play by ear.
Listen
to a song and start plunking away at it. Reading music was never really easy for me, and half of that was my ADHD. I had my focus or my attention span really could easily go from like the sheet music to what I'm playing, and then all of a sudden I want to play another song, so forget the sheet music, I'm off to the next song, and
you know
it happened over and over and over until I was like, nope, I can't do piano lessons anymore. I've just got to go with it. I've just got to go by ear and you know, learn everything.
Well, especially when you already have an idea of what you want to say lyrically and how you want the story to feel, the music has got to enhance that with the kind of the temperament and actually help with the emotion that you're going to be singing about, which you did so well in the last song.
Thank you so much.
Oh, it's beautiful song. So when you have to yourself have finished a song, where do you get to the point where you go out and you are ready to perform it?
So to be completely honest, at least for me, I'm never totally ready to perform an original. Originals are...
So you test it, then.
Yes. Yeah. Originals are very much a personal thing, at least for me. Yep. And it's like you're writing music, but you're also expecting it to be judged by the rest of the world. So yep. A lot of people will like it or a lot of people won't like it. And I feel like that always puts some form of a weight on there where you've got to be like, okay, I've got to practice this so I feel like it's perfect.
Yep.
And there have been songs where I haven't performed them for months, if not even a year.
Yeah.
But they've been written, they've been sitting there waiting to be played, and, you know, I'm sitting there for like a month or two practicing away at it because I'm just like, it's not ready. I can't bring it out yet.
Yeah. Well, we love that last song. That was great. We're talking with Nadia Robertson, and we have time for one more song, honey.
Yes. Okay. Yep. So speaking of musical inspirations, when I was younger, my voice was a lot higher in range. And as I grew older, that range expanded itself by a lot. I mean, I went from a Celine Dion to a Cher quickly. So one of my inspirations was Cher, actually. So I'm going to do a song by her called Believe. You keep pushing me aside and I can't break through. There's no talking to you. It's so sad that you're leaving. It takes time to believe it. But after all that's said and done, you're gonna be the lonely one. I guess that I'm too good for you. Oh, do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough, no. But I know that I'll get through this, because I know.
Yeah.